Hey, what's up guys, Austin here, and today I'm bringing a highly requested video. This is my room tour slash desk tour slash setup tour, whatever you want to call it. This is where I live and the stuff that I use to make my videos. I thought it'd be interesting to give you guys a walkthrough and a first-hand look at how I make my dorm look less like a prison, so let's go ahead and get right into it. So first thing you'll see when you walk into my room is the box to my custom built PC. If you want to check out the whole building process, I'll leave a link in the description, but it's just used to transport my computer to and from school. I'm a student and I do live right on campus. Also, because I live in a tiny single, I try to maximize my space, so I have my dresser hidden away in my closet, and there's really not much to see here, just some clothes, some essentials for when I'm getting up in the mornings, and some shoes. For most of you that don't know me outside of YouTube, I've collected a decent amount of shoes over the years. In fact, that's one of the reasons I'm doing this video, so you guys can see a bit more personal side of me and connect on a deeper level rather than just the tech videos I put out. I love technology, but I love other things too. Anyways, getting back on track, right outside my closet, I have my fridge with my printer placed right on top. It's like a really cheap wireless printer. I think I got it for like 30 bucks at Walmart. Anyways, as you can see, I have my Chromebook sitting right on top of it, and I did an unboxing of it earlier, but it really doesn't see too much use because I have two other computers. Right above, I have one of my softboxes, and for those of you asking, I got the 1600 watt softbox kit off of Amazon for about 100 bucks. They're really nice and bright and allow me to get clear shots, but the only downside is their size, and they take about 15 minutes to break down when I'm traveling. In between them, I have a set of 3 tie mats and Breaking Bad posters. If you haven't listened to your friends that keep telling you to check out Breaking Bad, just do it. It's one of the greatest shows you ever watch. Anyways, you can get these posters at the official Breaking Bad store, but I ordered mine a bit earlier, so I got signed copies. Right underneath, across from my desk, I have a couch with this I Heart Maryland sign sitting on it. And if you watch my videos, you probably have noticed some of my Maryland shirts I've worn, so yeah. Another thing to point out is this Barcelona book bag one of my closest friends got for me in Spain. If you're not familiar, this is the greatest soccer team ever. Period. At the end of the room, there's not much else I can show you. There's my bed and my window. I also have a little poster I picked up at a health fair I have hung up. It's usually the first thing people see when they walk in the room, and I thought it was kind of funny. In between my bed and my desk is my computer. Again, I did an entire series on the channel building this thing from scratch, but if you're not familiar, it has a 4770K, GTX 760, and 16 gigs of RAM, and I primarily use it for video editing and some gaming. For those of you who want updates, it's been running great, but the fans on the H100i are really loud, so I plan on replacing them when I get the chance. So here we are, this is what most of you came here to see, my desk setup. It's always under constant improvement, and I've probably added stuff since you last seen it, so let's get started. First of all, don't ask about the ancient phone, but here's something that I use on a daily basis. This is my iPod Classic from 07, and I know what you're thinking, what the hell, Austin? Well, it's still working perfectly, and it has 80 gigs of storage, so I don't really see the need to replace it. Next to it, something I use quite frequently, and you guys know what it is, that's the Zoom H1 handy recorder. Really useful if you have to record something on the go or just have a backup audio for your DSLR. Here's the computer I use the most, my ASUS ZenBook UX32VD, and this thing is a beast. It has an i7 processor, 10 gigs of RAM, a 1080p screen, an NVIDIA graphics card, and SSD. I can use it for anything. I use it for writing code, rendering videos, playing games, browsing the web. This is literally the best laptop I've ever owned, and I've had quite a few. Anyways, I highly recommend it if you want something really sleek, but also a really well-built machine. A recent addition to the audio setup, these are my Audio-Technica ATH-M50s. Now, I went without a decent set of headphones for quite some time and it drove me crazy, so I finally picked these up a couple weeks ago and haven't had any problems with them so far. They sound really good, especially considering the price. And they're usually connected to my audio interface, the Focusrite Scarlett 2i2. And I actually did a video recently covering everything in my audio setup, so feel free to check that out. As far as studio monitors, I'm using the Fostex PMO.5N active near-field monitors, and they provide an accurate sound, which is pretty important to me because I listen to a variety of music, so I appreciate having high-quality speakers that don't try and overcompensate. And I listen to just about everything. My iTunes goes from Kendrick Lamar straight to Neutral Milk Hotel, so I really love having great sound from these. The keyboard I'm using is the Rosewill RK9000i mechanical keyboard. It has Cherry MX Blue switches, so it has that audible tactile click, and it also comes in a sick black and white color that matches everything else on my desk. My monitor, actually recently updated, is the 27-inch Dell UltraSharp U2711 model, and this thing is absolutely incredible. It has a professionally calibrated 2560 by 1440 IPS panel, and it just makes everything so sharp and so accurate. There's so much free real estate on the screen for programs like Adobe Premiere, and it was a really good upgrade from my Dell S2740L, which is still a great and fairly new 27-inch 1080p monitor. Now, another huge bonus the UltraSharp has is the card reader right on the side. Now, I deal with a ton of media, obviously, doing this YouTube stuff, so it's really easy to just pop an SD card in the side and forget about it. And I also don't have to reach out to my computer or anything, so, I mean, forget about 4K, I think I'm good for now. Some other gear I have right here, I have a Canon 50mm f1.8, a really great beginner prime lens, as well as the kit lens and a speed light I use for photography. Near the middle is the microphone I'm using to record the audio. That's the Sennheiser MKE600. Really great audio for a shotgun mic considering its price. And last but not least, the camera I use to record all this, the Canon T3i with a Sigma 1835 f1.8. Best lens I've ever used. Anyways, that's it for the video. Comment, rate, subscribe. You guys know the deal. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.